Morgan Bueller surfs in the morning and has no problem waiting till lunch to eat.
I just would wake up and exercise and then not eat until like 11 or 12, and I felt great.
She lost 8 pounds by exercising first, fueling up later. One of the many on the latest diet trend known as intermittent fasting.
I eat dinner probably like 7 or 8. And then normally go like 16 hours before my next meal.
Bueller didn't know it, but she was trying the 8-hour diet that proposes eating what you want for 8 hours, then fasting for 16, even skipping breakfast.
You know, this is brand new science. This is a plan that basically says you can eat all your calories in your day, but you're going to start eating in 8-hour windows, even just 3 days a week. So it could be 11 to 7, 9 to 5,
but it's controversial, and it goes against some of the things we're about to talk about, go against what we've been taught for years. And the claims are pretty dramatic. You say if you follow this diet, you'll look younger, you'll feel younger, and you'll dramatically reduce your risk for getting some of the major diseases of our time.
Right. And the problem is that we're sleeping less than ever, we're working more than ever, and we're eating throughout the day. We're grazing all day long. We are not giving our bodies a chance to process all of the food that we're taking in and all the toxins, and by feasting for 8 hours
and then
fasting
16
for
hours
16,
of famine,
and even just 3 days a week, you're going to reset your body and get on that path. I lost 7 pounds in 10 days when I adopted the plan.
And you say, by the way, people could lose 20 pounds in 6 weeks. All right, let's start.
Every day what I do is I eat for 8 hours and I fast for 16. And so from about 10 in the morning till 6, for this I eat way too much, and then nothing after that. It's very unsociable.
Lousy for your social life.
Very bad.
Going out for dinner, I was like, we're going to get to the restaurant before 7, before like the bewitching hour. Yeah. Okay, last drink.
But the thing I didn't realize in the first one, 70% of how you look is your diet. So I thought it was all about weights and lifting and the gym. And yes, you have to train hard, but that's not nearly as important as the diet.
The type of intermittent fasting that I like the best is you don't eat for a period of 12 to 16 hours every day, and then you eat the rest of the time. That might sound like a long period of time, but I'll explain how it's not actually that difficult. But the benefits are really vast. Giving the body that break from eating decreases insulin levels. Insulin is something we have a tremendous problem with in this country. High insulin or having insulin resistance is associated not only with obesity, but the number one killer's heart disease. It's also associated with diabetes. So having insulin levels lower is very much associated with intermittent fasting, and that's a very good thing.
Researchers across the U.S. have been finding astonishing results from severe calorie restriction, decreased cancer risk, increased life expectancy, even improved brain function.
There also seems to be a very strong brain protection response that occurs with intermittent fasting. There was a doctor, Mattson, who did some research, and he found that what fasting did was it actually stimulated the defense network in the brain against cells being damaged. There was another study that looked at a specific protein that actually slows the rate of death of neurons or our nerve cells. So there have been a lot of studies showing that with Alzheimer's and Parkinson's that patients who did the intermittent fasting fared much better as far as just their cognitive ability, their memory. So it seems very brain protecting, as well as being anti-inflammatory, and inflammation we know is the initiator of most degenerative diseases. It increases our immune function, it lowers cholesterol and triglycerides. So overall, there's a lot of positive.